students, in the manufacturing technology, we have been going through the foundry technology. So in the foundry technology, our purpose is to make product with help of casting processes. So in today's session, we are going to discuss on some special or various casting processes, right? So in the previous session, we have discussed the concept of casting process and various things in casting process. So let's start our discussion with help of few casting processes, right? So in the casting processes, here I mentioned the various processes that we are going to discuss in this session. So let's start our discussion with sand casting. So as per the name, in this casting process, sand will be used for making the mold, right? So as per the name, this process is known as a sand casting because sand is used for making the mold, right? So by making the mold and by pouring our metal, we can solidify our liquid metal and our final product will be ready, right? So this process is known as a sand casting process, right? So with help of the sand casting process, we can make any component with help of cavity or say with help of by making the mold and cooling and solidification, right? So after that, here I mentioned the shell mold casting process. So here, as per the name, shell will be formed and this shell can be utilized for making the mold, right? So here, pattern will not be used. We can produce the cavity by making this shell or say by making our mold with help of shell, right? So as per the name shell mold casting here, shell can be formed in first stage and after that this shell can be utilized for making the mold, right? So how can we make the shell? Let's have a look on various views, right? So here first of all, we have to take some geometry or in simple word pattern, right? So as per our final component design, we have to select the pattern according to that shape. So by putting the pattern over some box and after that what happens? Our sand can be taken in the box with some binder or say with some resin grinder, right? So after that we have to put our heated pattern over that box. What happens? We have to rotate our box by 180 degree or say we have to revert our box by 180 degree, right? So what happens? All the sand with resin binder will be coming in the contact with our pattern or say with our geometry. So what happens? With help of or say because of this resin binder, a thin shell will be solidified around our pattern geometry. It means our thin shell will be formed because of the resin or so because of this binder, right? So after that what happens? We have to take our box in original position and after that what happens? We can strip off or we can take out our shell that is formed at the geometry or say at the boundary of our pattern, right? So here I mentioned all the steps with different images, right? So we have to put this type of shells in the oven so that what happens, our final shell will be in hard in nature, right? So that we can use that shell in our casting process, right? So here I mentioned by putting in oven and after taking out from oven, we can strip off or we can take out our shell that will be at the outer boundary of our pattern, right? So by making this type of shells and by making cavity with help of the shells, we can pour our liquid metal and after that cooling and solidification, our final product will be ready, right? So this is how we can use the shell mold casting, right? So this is the product that is made with help of shell mold casting, right? So after that, here I mentioned the permanent mold casting. So as per the name here, in the permanent mold casting, what happens? As per the name here, mold will be used of metal. It means we can use our permanent mold. It means here sand will not be used. So in the sand casting, what happens after one product manufactured, we have to break our mold. But here, one mold can be used for mass production because our mold is made of metal. That's why this process is known as permanent mold casting. And after one product or after one process, our mold will be utilized over and over. So we can use the same mold over and over for making a product in mass production. Right? So here, a metal mold or say metal die will be used, right? So with help of some hydraulic mechanism, we can operate our mold, right? So as per the name here, metal mold or say permanent mold will be used, right? So here I mentioned the view for the cavity or say the cavity formed between two plates or say two dies, right? So here one part is steady and another can be moved, right? So here cavity can be formed in between two parts, right? So by moving one part, we can take out our product. So here metal can be poured in between the two dies or say two parts. So here after cooling and solidification, final product can be taken out by movable part moving in outward direction, right? So here I mentioned this view. By moving a movable part, we can take out our product. So here I mentioned the final product that can be made with help of this permanent mold casting, right? So after that, here I mentioned the investment casting process. So as per the name here, investment casting process is very interesting process, and this process is also known as a lost wax process, right? So this process is also known as a lost wax process. So here wax patterns are used, and this process is very useful for mass production of small parts. So here wax can be used for making the patterns, or say here wax is used, right? So how can we execute this process? So let's start our discussion, or say let's have a look on process steps. So here first step is to make a wax pattern. For example, we are going to make this type of bucket shape in mass production. First of all, we have to make this type of shape with help of wax, right? So here wax patterns are used. So by making this type of different parts, we have to combine or we have to make a tree of this type of parts together, right? So if, for example, if we want to make four items at a time, we can make a four wax patterns and attach with the tree, right? So whole tree is made of wax, right? So in the investment casting process, wax is used. So what happens after that? We have to dig that our pattern tree in some refractory slurry. So slurry is nothing but it is a very thick liquid. So here refractory grains slurry will be used. So by dig our tree in refractory slurry, what happens? A layer or say one thin layer of refractory material will be formed in outer part of our pattern tree, right? So there will be a thin layer formed on our over our pattern tree, right? So what happens after? We have to take this type of tree with refractory slurry and we have to give the heat around this type of tree. So what happens? With help of this heat, our wax will be melted, and this melted wax will be taken out and can be drained out by the lower part. So what happens? Cavity will be created at the place of the wax, because here refractory is very hard material, right? So at the outer boundary there will be a refractory material and hollow space created at place of the wax, because with help of heat whole wax will be melted out and can be drained out by the lower part, right? So what happens after that? We can pour our liquid metal, because here hollow space will be created in between this refractory slurry, right? So our slurry can hold a high temperature metal, right? So after cooling and solidification, we can cut our parts, that is desired part, with help of this investment casting, right? So this is very simple and interesting process. So after that, here I mentioned the vacuum casting process. So as per the name here, vacuum will be used for making the mold, right? So how can we make the mold with vacuum? Let's have a look on this process or say various steps in the process. So as per the name here, vacuum is used for making the sand mold, right? So here I mentioned, first of all, we have to take a pattern and one plastic sheet, right? So by taking or say by drawing this plastic sheet over this type of pattern by vacuum, we can have this type of geometry or our final product, right? So here, as per our final product, we can take this type of pattern and by drawing the plastic sheet over this type of pattern, this is the first step, right? So after first step, here I mentioned the second one, we have to fill our sand over this type of pattern. After that, another plastic sheet can be drawn over this molding sand layer, right? So here in the lower part there will be a plastic sheet, in between two plastic sheets there will be a molding sand, right? So by taking the vacuum or by draining the air, what happens here, plastic shield or say plastic sheet can be sealed, and between two plastic sheets there will be our molding sand, right? So this is how we can make a mold. So after that, what happens, because we remove all the airs and between two plastic sheets there will be a molding sand, right? So here I mentioned, by pouring the liquid metal in this type of mold, our final product will be ready after cooling and solidification, right? So here, this is very simple process. We can remove the air by vacuum and between two plastic sheets there will be a molding sand, right? So this is how we can make this type of product with help of vacuum casting, right? So after that, here I mentioned the plaster or say ceramic casting. So if we use the plaster or ceramic material in place of sand, this process will be known as plaster or say ceramic casting, because ceramic will be having a high refractory strength. It means ceramic can withstand against high temperature, so that it can withstand against a liquid metal, right? So plaster can be used in place of sand, as well as ceramic powder can be also used in place of sand. So this process is known as a plaster casting or ceramic casting. So every other thing will remain same. In place of sand, we can use the plaster or say ceramic. So with help of ceramic, you can make a temperature or say we can make a metal will be having a higher melting temperature, or in simple words, ceramic can withstand a high temperature, right? So this is the concept for this processes. So here I mentioned the important fact or difference between plaster and ceramic casting. So as per my discussion, ceramic will be having a high temperature sustainability, right? Because ceramic can withstand the high temperature, right? So this is all about various special casting processes. Thank you all of you.